Hello students, you already worked with numbers. You must have seen many arithmetic expressions involving two numbers using arithmetic operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Right? Let us see. You have to subtract 19 from 85. What will be the reason? Yes. Subtracting 19 from 85, you will get 66. Let's see. You have to solve this expression. What will you perform first? Will you add, subtract, or multiply? How are you going to solve this expression? Yes. Today we are going to discuss that which operation will perform first while solving such expression. When an expression contains brackets and multiple operations, we use Bormos rule. What is that? Bormos rule helps us to decide which operation should be carried out first while solving such an expression. Let us see. Each letter stands for. So B stands for bracket. O stands for order. Involving over stands for division. A stands for multiplication. A stands for addition. A stands for subtraction. Bormos rule says that an expression containing brackets first need to be simplified brackets. Brackets are followed by order, includes roots of power. Then we solve division, multiplication, addition, and subtraction. But can you see why Bormos rule meant? Why we cannot solve any operation first? Let us see with example.
2 into 4 plus 5 minus 2.
It's equal to 2 into 4 plus 5 is equal to 9 minus 2. 9 into 2, 18 minus 2. It's equal to 16. If we solve in another sequence, then we'll get equal to 11.
For the same expression, we get two different answers, but in the maths, we cannot have two different answers from same expression. So, we need to make Bormos rule. Before solve examples of Bormos rule, we'll learn about types of brackets.
This is line bracket, this is simple bracket, curly bracket and square bracket.
While solving expression containing brackets, we have to follow the sequence that first line bracket, second simple bracket, third curly bracket, fourth square bracket. Now we'll solve expression by using Bormos rule. In this expression, line bracket is there, curly bracket is there, or square bracket. So first of all, we'll solve line bracket. So when we solve line bracket, rest whole expression will copy down as it is in the second step. So
4 plus 19 plus curly bracket, 7 plus 3 is 10 minus 8 plus 9
bracket comes. Now we'll solve curly bracket.
So rest whole expression will write as it is.
Now here 10 minus 8 is 2, 2 plus 9 is 11.
Now we'll solve square bracket. So 4 plus 19 plus 11 is equal to 30. Now 4 plus 30 is equal to 34. So 34 is a answer.
Second expression. In this expression, simple bracket is here, curly bracket is here, and square bracket is here. So According to sequence, first of all we'll solve simple bracket. So rest whole expression will copy down as it is in the second step.
So it's equal to 8 plus 9 plus curly bracket 5 plus
19 minus 4 is equal to 15
divided by 3 plus 4 minus 1.
Student, remember that just we solve here simple bracket and whatever solution of that only we change rest whole expression, we copy down as it is. Now we'll solve curly bracket.
So here 8 plus 9 plus,
now we'll solve curly bracket here, 5 plus 15 divided by 3. So according to Bodmer's rule, we'll solve division first and then addition. So 15 divided by 3 is equal to 5 plus 5 is equal to 10 plus 4 minus 12. Now we'll solve square bracket. In the square bracket all integers are positive, so just we'll add them. So 8 plus 9 is 17 plus 10 27 plus 4 31
minus 12, it's equal to 19. So answer is 9.